When you work with Azure every day, you're often thinking of ways to make your work efficient and quick. Working with the Azure CLI is one of those ways that you can cut minutes from a task and have time for Lego. I mean, more cloud. Yes. The Azure Command Line Interface, referred to as the Azure CLI, is a tool for creating and managing Azure resources. It is all text-based with no graphical interface and is developed with an emphasis on efficiency. When you work with Azure every day, the CLI can save you a lot of time compared to using, say, the portal. Creating a resource in the portal involves a wizard, which has many button clicks, drop-downs, fields, pages of information to fill in, and more. It takes several minutes to complete. And if you create resources often enough, those minutes become hours, days, and weeks, and months, you know. Using the CLI instead, you can use a single command, or perhaps two, to create or manage the resource. It takes seconds, maybe a minute. In this video, I'll show you how to get started with the Azure CLI by showing you how to execute some basic CLI commands, both on desktop and in what's called the CloudShell. But before I get into that, first, let's learn how to install it. To install the Azure CLI on your local machine, you use the Microsoft Docs page for the Azure CLI install. Now, the link to that is in the resources for this particular video. Now, in this case, I have the Azure CLI for Windows. And if you scroll down a little bit here, there is a current release of the Azure CLI. If I click on that, it will download a pretty stock standard MSI install file, like so. I can open it, and it's just a completely standard install experience, like we're used to. Click next, 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 etc. Now, I have already installed it on this machine, so I can choose to repair it. But if you haven't, you can install it, and then we'll be up and running with the Azure CLI. So let me show you that. And then we just have a standard Windows command prompt here. And now the Azure CLI commands will work in here. So I could do an AZ login command, which is the command to log in to the Azure CLI. That will open up a sign-in form here. I'm now logged into my Azure account, and I can now use the Azure CLI. Another way to use the Azure CLI is through the what's called the Cloud Shell. If you go to shell.azure.com, it'll take you through the login process again if you haven't logged in already, and you'll get to this screen here where you have to choose Bash or PowerShell. Now, Bash is just like a Windows command prompt, so I'm going to use that in order to use the Azure CLI. So this is a complete online experience. It's all in the browser. So the first thing you need to do is to attach a storage account or a storage device or service to your CloudShell, because it has to store all the metadata and certain files you might upload. It has to store that somewhere. So in this case, I'm going to create a storage because we don't have any storage. And once the storage is created, it'll just create it for you, by the way. You don't have any choice on naming, etc. It will create the storage, and then we're now logging into the Bash shell of the CloudShell, or the Bash experience of the CloudShell, and that allows us to use the Azure CLI. So it says here we can type AZ to use Azure CLI, so we can type AZ. And that'll give me all of the different commands that are available for the Azure CLI. So that is another way of using the Azure CLI. So there's the desktop experience where you install the CLI and use a command prompt. There's the Cloud Shell, which is a complete experience in the browser. And then there's actually another way to use the Cloud Shell is if you're in the portal, up here you can click the little terminal button here that also says Cloud Shell, and it'll open up sort of half a screen. I mean, you can adjust how much you want this to fill up. And it is also the Cloud Shell experience, but you have it sort of inside the portal. And that could be useful if you are learning how to use the Cloud Shell or the Azure CLI. You can see what happens in the portal at the same time as you create and manage resources. So those are three ways of using the Azure CLI. So now let's move on to a bit more theory. There are many ways to interact with Azure and manage resources. The CLI is just one of them. For this reason, there needs to be a service to manage all of the requests from various tools and then forward those requests to Azure. Otherwise, Azure would have to implement a new set of features every time a new tool was created. This management layer is called the Azure Resource Manager, and all tools, without exception, wanting to talk to Azure have to go through it. The Azure CLI is one of those tools. In other words, the CLI talks to a software development kit or SDK that then talks to the Azure Resource Manager, which then talks to the Azure resources. This ensures a consistent management layer that also authenticates and authorizes each request. The portal is often used for troubleshooting and learning about new services, but the CLI is mostly used for creating resources and environments day to day. If you create scripts of Azure CLI commands, these can also be used to automate certain tasks, and they can also be added to source control tools, versioned and peer reviewed. Let's have a look at a couple of the commands that you can use with the Azure CLI. So I'm in the CloudShell again. That is probably the easiest shell to use because it's always available if you have a computer with an internet connection. So let's start with AZ account and then list, which means we want to list all the accounts that are available to this particular login. So you can see there's one there, ACGTA, last client. Another good tip is that you can always go dash dash help. So say I wanted to know something about VMs, I can go AZ VM dash dash help. And that will give me all of the commands, if I'm just scroll up a bit here, all of the commands available at that point for a AZ VM command. As in, this says I can use AZ VM create. Okay, so let's try that. AZ VM create. And then I can do dash dash help again, and I get all of the available commands at that point of the command. And then you can sort of build it up from there. So if I scroll up, there's a whole lot. VMs have a lot of commands. But you can see there's all sorts here. You can put in dash dash VM SS, name or ID of an existing virtual machine, scale set, etc., etc. So dash dash help is always available at any point on any command. And that's really useful if you're kind of stuck and can't remember or want to know what the options are for that particular point in a command. Let me just go back down here to where we were. So that's sort of just how you use the Azure CLI. If you want to know more about all of the commands that are available and how to use them, I have linked to a reference in the resources, but I also other videos in the AZD Fundamentals series on how to use specific things in the Azure CLI world. So I hope you enjoyed it. All right, back to my face.
The Azure CLI is a tool that you will use all the time once you start working with Azure every day. It makes it more efficient to carry out those day-to-day tasks, so there is more time for shenanigans, probably. If you want to learn more about the Azure CLI and start using it for managing resources, check out some of the other ACG Fundamental episodes on that topic. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to this channel for everything cloud computing. And all there's left to say is then, keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus.